First of all, to start this review, let's ask ourselves a question. Does Stargron needs to be in VR? And the answer is no, it don't have to, but the best way to play and experience Stargron is on PlayStation VR. And now I gonna start proceed to my review and let you know about the all shenanigans of this game. So in my news videos few days ago, I was wondering how you will control the game, will it be touchpad or something, and how stupid and silly I was. You control it with your head because you aim with your head and you press in one button to hold it, you know, to get the ship attached to the the things what attaching the ship, and then you letting go in order to let the ship fly in the direction you want it to fly. I'm so terrible at explaining stuff, but I did my best for you. So what's the purpose of this game? What's the message? What is the message? And the message is, have fun, enjoy the game, it's a puzzling, spicy, flying, fucking thinking game. You collecting stars and doing random stuff like marking some things on the fucking stage. Sorry for terrible explanations of things, sometimes you struggle when you're foreign. Hard to get my point across, but hopefully you can see the gameplay on the screen. And by passing the stages, you unlocking some more stages. And that's how you progressing, you've got 60 stages altogether, which is very nice amount. And the game is sold for a very good price of $7.99. I think they would got away with $9.99, so it's nice for them for selling it for cheap. Because from all the budget games, this one is really, really good. Good price for a good game. It don't seem much, it seems like you could play it in VR. You can't play it in VR, what I meant to fucking say is, it seems like you could play it in non-VR as well, because you can, of course, but it's just not better feeling, like just look up and see all the whole big stage and how big they are. You know, when you see it in non-VR, it's just a stage for your spaceship to fly around, for you to think a bit, find your best ways, your best trajectories. But when you play it in VR, it changes to a very much better experience, because everything is so big. There is a bit of depth to it, they added like a little stars what sticks out. You know, particle effects are really nice in this game, really digging them. And the graphics can be a bit trippy, which is great as well, because who don't like tripping in VR? So, to end this review, first of all my final thoughts of them all, the thoughts which I just projected to you in this review, is that I am very satisfied with my purchase. Very simple game to pick up and very difficult to master. I love saying it, I've been waiting on review to say it. Graphics are clear enough, sharp enough, soundtrack is really good, I really like the soundtrack, the controls are amazing, there's no better control than your head, than aiming with your head. So just to end, would I recommend it or would I not? I would definitely recommend it, especially for the cheap price they sell it for. And that's it from me, I hope you enjoyed the review, if you did, hit like and subscribe and I'll be back.